David Curley with the breaking events overnight. David?
Good morning, Robin. As you just said, this location where the satellite spotted something in the water is right down here off Australia. But here's what's interesting about this. This was the search area, but these two satellite photos came from outside the area. But as you mentioned, one official says this is the best lead we have had since the 777 disappeared.
While the search planes are looking for the debris spotted on the satellite images, could this actually be part of the Malaysian 777? Yes. At least one of the pieces spotted in the ocean is 78 feet long. That's big, but not too big to be part of the 777, which is 242 feet long and has a 200-foot wingspan. Finding just pieces of the plane or luggage can yield many clues. Was there a fire? How did the wide-body jet hit the water? And then there is the flight track of Malaysian 370, that hard left bank off its flight path to Beijing, then turns after crossing over Malaysia before heading out to the ocean. Officials say they were able to glean new details from those satellite pings from the jet, that with calculating the fuel remaining on board, this X marks the spot is very close to the original search area and where Flight 370 could have run out of fuel. And this area off Australia is where U.S. sources have been telling ABC News for nearly a week is the most likely spot the plane could have gone down. Debris could have drifted significantly by now, so the Australians are flying a C-130 aircraft over the area to drop data buoys, which will measure the currents, allowing experts to backtrack the debris closer to a possible crash site. And while officials call these images promising, they warn that finding parts of the plane at the bottom of the ocean may be difficult. The average depth of the Indian Ocean, 14,000 feet, and this area is known as the Roaring Forties, southern latitudes notorious for wild weather, waves, and currents that could move debris at a breakneck pace.
It is a really tough spot to search here. You're basically on the way to the South Pole. What we really need at this point, George, is the Australians to report back exactly what they're seeing today down under.